treat you right. You're the reason I'm alive. You're the only pain I can endure. And when you're not here,
from the start, you my bunny, I'm your clock. From now to eternity, I give you all my heart. We are meant to be, it's clear to see. My love is bigger than I thought. I got everything I want when I hold you with my arm. Yeah, there's no matter my love and my pleasure. The key to my treasure, whatever's the weather. Day up and out with you till I die. How many times for you, I'ma try. Want you to notice the one and I know this. Perfect soulmate, I wanna show my best friend. She saved my life, my happy end in hard times.
Guys, how's it going? Just getting a noise gate's probably a little off right now till I get things going. How's everybody doing tonight? All right, here we go. I do have Facebook up and I have the Beam chat up. So if anybody wants to talk at either one of those locations, I can read the questions, chat with you there. Heart rate is not really that high. Takes a few minutes to get a little sweat going. Thanks, Chuck. We're gonna run over to the volcano circuit here. And we are going to run up the volcano climb. Not been on the treadmill for I think 2 weeks. This will be interesting. Yeah, since with this, my heart rate strap is it usually picks up like your run cadence or my shirt blowing around until I get a little bit of sweat going. Hey, Carissa, how's it going? Not seeing any chat over at Facebook yet. Hopefully my chat on Facebook is working. Had a little bit of Facebook chat issues last time I did this. There we get the heart rate. Now it's picking up cadence. That's my run cadence. But it's picking up here. Hopefully we have decent luck with the setup tonight. I'm actually set up on my laptop tonight. I didn't want to drag my whole computer setup out to the treadmill this time. I'm doing pretty good, Carissa. Busy day today, but getting some good exercise in tonight. Doing something a little different. Hopefully my heart rate drops back down here in a few minutes. Get some real numbers going. My heart rate really is probably in the 120s, maybe the 130s. Part of my issue is my Garmin heart rate strap. Just about completely out of elastic. Chris, I've mentioned that a few times before. I think the color coding is actually pretty awesome up there for the run. And I think it would be interesting to do something with that. Yeah, Chuck, it probably is time for a new one. I saw somewhere where, with a code, I think you could get this old cheap style one for under 20 bucks. I don't remember where it was at. But mine's the old cheap, uncomfortable Garmin one, but I've always been happy with it. Yeah, I think I change batteries in my heart rate strap about twice a year. Rogers, how's it going? I changed it to turn right here so I can get a faster, more direct route to the climb. I'm not going to push the pace tonight because it's been so long since I've ran. Doing well. Charles says the Scorche heart rate monitor is the best out there. Scorche. I've seen that name before. Not familiar with that one. I've got a Viva heart rate strap as well. And it works really well. It just goes through more battery because it's got the ANT Plus bridge in it as well. That's a nice time, Rogers. Good job. See how long I have to go before my heart rate comes down into normal territory here. Okay, so Charles, that's a optical one. I can't click the link right now, but is that a wrist-based optical monitor? My watch here has, my Garmin watch has an optical monitor in it as well. Okay, James, yeah, I'm getting, Charles is talking about that same monitor over at Facebook. So it's a, he said it's something you wear on your forearm that's an optical. It probably works a little better than the wristwatch ones. Hey Carol, how you doing? When I did the Roanoke event, I had to use my wrist because there was so much noise in the room with ANC Plus that my monitor, my chest strap wasn't working. And I just tightened up my watch a little bit. And it seemed to work pretty well, actually. Charles, I'll have to check that out sometime. This is going to look like a really hard workout with this heart rate. I am using a foot pod, Scott. I'm using a Garmin foot pod. Yeah, Chuck, I'm probably around 130 right now. As soon as I get a little more sweat going, it'll drop down. Carissa, I found that mine is, it's pretty obvious when mine's not right. If I tighten it up on my wrist, it's pretty good. My pace right now is fairly accurate. I'm probably 15 seconds a mile fast right now. The Garmin foot pod, I have had to do a little adjustment with and move it around on my shoe to get the pace just right. Because there is no calibration that you can do with an ANC Plus foot pod in Zwift right now. So that's been something I've had to play with a little bit. Some of the Bluetooth foot pods will store a calibration in the foot pod. So those will be a little more accurate. Yeah, Big Mac, mine, my wrist-based one can be inaccurate, but it's not like you're like 10 beats off. When it's off, it's off. So, it's like it's missing a ton of stuff. Right now, the issue is it's picking up my run cadence. So the 165 is actually my run cadence. The bouncing is overriding the little heart rate pickups. But any second now it should pick up and you'll watch it drop probably right into the blue or the green zone. So Luke, overall, the pace is a little bit off, depending on who you are, how you run, how well your calibration is, but you can get it pretty close. Yeah, Carissa. I usually just click it and stick it on. I've actually had it on for like 30 minutes before I started. Probably why it's not working very well. I'm going up the hill, Chuck, so you can come find me on the hill if you want. We're gonna go up the volcano climb. Okay, here we go. Getting the heart rate down to 140s now. That's probably closer to accurate. Trying to pick it up now. Yeah, the running animation is not perfect. I still think 150 heart rate is probably a little high for me right now, but it may be right. I'm pretty fatigued today too. Chuck, I'm gonna try to do an hour, roughly 6 miles. That's my plan anyway. We'll see how the legs hold out. And I've got the time trial bike on the trainer. Probably gonna jump over to the trainer, do a little pedaling over there when I'm done. I was originally thinking like full on rest day. I think I might have a busy schedule tomorrow, and I might use tomorrow as a rest day. Big Mac, it depends. Sometimes it's higher than normal. Fatigue. At a steady effort, mine will be higher than normal, like a zone 2 effort, it'll run high. But if I tried to do like a sprint, I couldn't get it up into the real high range very well. So I think it can go either way. Usually at lower intensities, it will be a little high, but when I go high intensity, it won't respond as well. Uh-huh. 160 is still high. I can tell by how well I'm talking, that's still pretty high for what I'm actually feeling. Carol, I have a script running that changes my view. So every like 10-15 seconds, auto hotkey is pushing a different number and sending it to Zwift to change my view. I would expect, guys, right now. Yeah, see, now it's getting down into real territory. Pretty sure anything in the yellow or the orange is not accurate to me right now. This 140, 135, 140 is probably right where it should be. Yeah, Chuck, I think that's age and genetics. As soon as we find the anti-aging pills, maybe our max heart rate will go up. Yeah, Carol, I set up the camera swapping for the run because at the lower pace, I think it's kind of boring and you get to see a little more of the landscape with a little bit of rotation in the cameras. Since we're not going so fast. Nice work, Rogers. Yeah, Chuck, the heart rate stuff is interesting because even me on Zwift, I've gotten up to about 8 beats per minute above anything I had ever done outside before Zwift. So I think that, you know, the motivation you have, and then a little less risk of falling off your bike. I am keeping an eye over at Facebook chat too, guys. Not seeing any new chats over there. Yeah, Chuck, I didn't fall or anything, but I did yank a foot out of a cleat. Two weeks ago, I guess it was. It was actually on Zwift Community Live. In a sprint, I yanked the shoe out of the cleat or out of the pedal. Still working on getting that heart rate settled in. At 150 is not right. 140 is, I think, the 137, 140 is more where I should be. Ah, 1200 watts, that's big numbers, Chuck. Nice work. And I'm actually getting a little sweat going now. Nice, Rogers. That's awesome. Getting ready for the race. Yeah, Carol, I would see that coming. Getting some running gear. Picking your visor or your hat or something. Ooh, 10 mile TT is too short. Those hurt. Sure, John, yeah. I think there's a park run that they run, a 5K group run at 0900 hours GMT on Saturday mornings. I would call it probably the first group run on Zwift that they've got set up. So some of the guys over at the Zwift Runners Forum have set that up. So the middle of the night for me, any of you EU folks, to check that out. You can do the virtual park run. I think I saw somewhere where they were trying to do one. It was a little more US time friendly. Maybe on Sundays too. Anybody interested in the running needs to go check out the Zwift Runners Forum on Facebook. You can get all kinds of info on the gear, the foot pods, what works, how to find the running portion of the app, and how to get set up with group rides. We talked about doing a duathlon maybe. Lots of cool stuff going on. And it's just, running is just in its infancy. So a lot of you have seen what we've done with the cycling over the last 2 years. The running's just getting started. Say what, the volcano route gives you some good views of the landscape around the island. See the mountain in the background. And there on the left, you can see the standard Watopia Hill. There's the tunnel coming from start finish. Now we've got a real heart rate, guys. That's more like it. Yeah, Big Mac, you're gonna have to get yourself a treadmill for next winter. I know you're a running beast. Where be the one that just said yesterday you did a 17 something, a sub 18 5K, and essentially just a weekend practice run. Richard, right now gradient is not adjusted for running, so running is strictly just a pace in the game based on my foot pod. It does not go up and down a pace wise for the gradient, nor does my treadmill adjust for it. Big Mac did a 726 5K. Whew. That's out of my league, buddy. We do have a biathlon here in May, thinking about getting after. It's a 5K followed by, I think, roughly a 20K bike, and we finish on the bike. I did it about 4 years ago, and I know I'd be quite a bit faster now than I was then. Looks like I got a runner. Who we got there? E something. It's hard for me to see the way my screen's laid out. Rogers, actually, we were second place in the relay. But my swimmer was my 7-year-old daughter. But we're going for broke this year. We're gonna win it. I'm gonna win the men's relay and the co-ed relay this year. I'm gonna ride the bike for both of them. Now, 2 years ago, let's say I was the winner of the local triathlon. There was actually a pro that's local that came home and did it. So he beat me, so I got second overall. But I tied the pro on the bike split down to the 10th of a second. We had identical bike times. We won't talk about the swim or the run time, because those weren't even close. But we had a little friendly banter going on about the bike split. So I was putting it all in for the bike that year. Thanks, Carissa. Yeah, G Woots is running with me. I can't see it. On the PC, your guys' beam chat's covering that up. And on the iPad, it's too small for me to see. Up there and give me a tow, buddy. I'll center this. That's awesome. That would actually be a fun distance. That's a little too much running for me, though. He did a 5K run, 15K bike, 5K run. So give me a little bit more on the bike and a little bit less on the run. A lot of the ones around here are like a, they'll do like a 5K, a 20K, and then like a 3K to finish or a 2K. It's like 1 mile to finish. Got a lot of folks watching over at Facebook, it looks like. Thanks for hanging out with me. Yeah, I definitely favor the cycling. So remember when I first started triathlon, swimming was completely foreign to me. And the first sprint try that I showed up to, they canceled the swim the night before the race, turned it into a duathlon due to water quality issues. So I got to crush my first triathlon because we skipped the swim. It was awesome. Oh, that's awesome, Richard. Got a Paralympic gold medal runner, one of the dads at his kid's school. Yeah, Big Mac, I mean, I'm a fair runner when I get some training in, but I'm never going to be competitive in just a straight out run. You know, smaller 5Ks, I'm competitive in my age group, but well, like 19 minutes is a rockin' 5K for me. I mean, that's like all out, best I've ever done. I'd love to clip under 19 just once. Yeah, Carol, I have found that if I do some running, it definitely helps my bike fitness. I'm not motivated to run like I am motivated to cycle though. So it is a challenge. That's gotta be Chuck cruising alongside me. Yep. I know he likes that alien jersey too. Careful, Chuck, it gets steep here in a second. We might run away from you. Even got the right color on the Tron bike there. So Big Mac, I gotta hear the tricks on how I go from breaking 19 minutes to running 17:20. I just can't even fathom how to make that leap or whether I want to do that much pain. Yeah, Carol, we have a lot more triathlon around here than we do, and a lot more 5Ks than we do any cycle racing, that's for sure. Yeah, Rogers. James Brown, I use Restream to multi-stream for my own purposes, but for Zwift Community Live, that group has its own software that it uses, and honestly, I don't know that setup very well, but they have a separate tool that they use for multi-stream. for my personal account, when I stream myself, I use Restream, and I go to Beam and Twitch both with that. No problem, James. Forget how long some of these circuits are on Zwift until you get out here running. It's like, oh, I'm gonna run up the volcano and come down and do a few laps. In reality, I'm not gonna do a lot once I get to the bottom. Yeah, Big Mac, actually, that's when my running transformed to commenting on weight. When I first started getting fit, I started a little over 200 pounds 7 years ago. And my first kind of drop, I dropped about 180, 175, 180. And I stayed there for about a year. That's when I started my running and I started dabbling in triathlon a little bit. Like my first 5K was 27 minutes, something like that. And then I kind of got my bug. End of that year, I did a duathlon at around that 175 pound weight. That's when I got the bug to get into triathlon for the next season. So I dropped from 175 to about 160, 155, 160 over that winter. And that completely transformed my run. Being able to drop that extra weight. And that next year is when I really started picking up the run pace and doing, in a triathlon, in a sprint try, I was capable of doing a sub 21 minute 5K at that point. Hey, nice work, Rogers. You're getting there, buddy. That's getting down there. I know for a cyclist, you still feel like a bigger guy, but 168's getting down there pretty trim for normal folk. Hey Lee, how's it going? I'm getting back down to about my lowest weight now. I was riding around 155. A couple of years ago, I dipped down to about 150 when I was really, really fit doing triathlon. And I've kind of maintained at 155, but I'm down to 150 again now. And we'll see how that goes. I don't have any big desire to drop anymore, but I'm not really going to worry about dropping a little bit more as long as I don't lose power. So if I end up down at 145, I'm okay with that as long as my training doesn't suffer. Lee, I don't do much core work right now, but I'm having to start do a little bit more because the harder I train, the more I start having back lower back pain if I don't get core work in. So I do a little bit more of like planks and some things like that when I do my stretching routines. Still don't do a lot. Yeah, Carissa, I'm trying to be really careful in watching my weight right now because I'm concerned if I lose much, I'm gonna sacrifice power. So I definitely am not gonna run a big calorie deficit, gonna strip any muscle away, and I have to be really careful even dropping any weight that I'm not pulling muscle. Locally we have they call a bod pod, the place where you can go and they measure you they weigh you, and then they weigh you underwater. So something about the different weights and densities and buoyancy, they can get to a very scientific muscle to fat, bone density stuff out of that. So I've been thinking about, now that I've got a good, I'm down to near my lowest weight again. I'm in really good cycling shape right now. I'm thinking about going and getting a baseline, spin to bod pod, and then getting like a withing scale or something like that. And I know they're not super scientific, but they're accurate enough to start giving me a baseline of percentage of body fat kind of thing, and start tracking that data a little bit more. Some things that I'm doing too that are helping, and it's still cycling, but I'm doing a lot more of that force work, the low cadence drills that are very similar to doing like high rep, low weight work in the weight room. So I'll do like 6 minute intervals at a 55 to 60 cadence. That's usually like a low FTP power number. And see you later, Lee. I use those kind of simulate muscle work, strength work. I don't have a good weight setup at home right now, and I've canceled my gym membership. So trying to use that as kind of a weight workout. Yeah, exactly, Carissa. I know it's not perfect, but it'll at least be a trending tool to tell if you're going up or down. I can use the bod pod as kind of a baseline, a base point, and then start measuring from there. Hey, Brian over there on Facebook, how's it going? So guys, I'm watching those on Facebook that don't know, and for those on Beam, I'm watching the chat on both of those locations. So some of the conversation I'm having is with the Beam chat, and some is with the Facebook chat. So feel free to chat with me on either one. Hey, Justin, thanks for that. I am monitoring both of those. We're also live at Twitch and YouTube, but I can't see those chats right now. Probably run for about an hour here. We'll go about 6 miles. Then we'll shut down here on Zwift Community Live. And my buddy Scotty will be back on here about an hour after I'm done. And he'll be doing his weekly training ride, which I may jump into that on the bike. But I'm gonna jump over to my Beam channel, do a little riding over there when I'm done here, I think. Yeah, Carissa, for sure. Yeah, Brian, you should check Zwift out. It's pretty awesome if you're into running or riding. So, Carissa, we used to have a lady in our local tri club that she was hosting, basically volunteering to doing a body flow class for the tri club once a week. I went to that a few times, and when I first did it, I'm like, oh, this is like not a guy thing, right? And I hurt so bad the next day. My abs, and just, it was awful, but it was a good kind of awful. I wish actually I had an opportunity to do something like that still. It was really good core work, but it was also relaxing and a lot of stretching too. one thing you find, the more you kind of get focused and really up the intensity and the volume that you're doing, that the lack of cross training really hurts you. And you start running into these aches and pains, and you really start running into some things that are unhealthy, out of balance muscles in your body that you have to start accounting for. You're keeping certain things stretched out because the cycling forces them to be tight. I have hip flexor problems from that I have to really stay on top of. I don't even know if I'm going to make it to the bottom of the hill, guys. A mile and a half will be about up and down and done. Hey, Brian, thanks for joining. Have a good night. My heart rate versus my leg feel right now clearly tells me how bad out of shape I am for running. Yeah, Rogers and a TT for sure. That equipment will make a big difference. Yeah, the rolling mass isn't that big of a deal on a TT, Rogers. It's all aero, man. Don't worry about the weight. Unless you're hills, I can't look at your course, but unless it's hills, that weight means nothing. I think my time trial bike has a wheel set on it that weighs over 2,500 grams. Hey Gert, thanks for hanging out with me. I appreciate you running with me. Gert's chatting with me over on the Facebook page. He's the guy running with me. Even in a wheel, it feels slow because it spins up a little slower. But if you're not constantly accelerating, once it's in motion, the wheel weight's not significant. So, like when I got my lightweight wheels on my road bike, just riding on the flat, they felt great because they spin up. You can feel that acceleration. But the actual, like being able to maintain a constant speed, I don't actually think it's significantly different. Because once the weight's up to speed, it's not a lot of extra power to hold it to speed. Yeah, the aero is huge, Rogers. I mean, I've got lightweight, like 1,300 gram lightweight wheels, and then I've got my 2,500 gram heavy aero wheels. I'll take them aero wheels all day long, unless I'm going up a mountain. That's actually true on the road bike, too. I live in flatland. Well, I don't ride my light wheels that much. I've got a set of 40 millimeter aluminum alloy wheels that came stock on my time trial bike that I actually ride on my road bike, because most everything around here is flat. This is not watts per kilogram. This is about time trial pacing. So Rogers, it's all about getting that head down out of the wind. Making sure everything's nice and efficient on the bike. Got the right tire pressure. Get rid of any wasted weight. So don't carry anything extra that you don't have to. Getting that head out of the wind. Getting a good tight fitting jersey and shorts. Nothing flapping in the wind. Unless you need to stay warm, get rid of the gloves. Shoe covers. Those are the things that'll make big differences. Yeah, for sure, Carissa. For sure. That's what time trialing is. Yeah, Rogers, I picked up from, I think it was Ribble. I picked up a Castelli skin suit, and that thing is awesome. Fantastic for time trials. I can't even stand up straight in the thing. It's so, it pulls your shoulders down so much. But, I mean, I only wear it in super competitive time trials. So it's hard to tell how much it's actually gaining me. But I wouldn't be shocked if it's not gaining me 0.2 mph over a 20K. I'm always faster with it, but I'm also more motivated because they're bigger races, so it's hard to know how much is the skin suit versus just my own personal motivation. Oh yeah, Carissa, that kind of stuff would make me crazy. Like, man, if you really want to take a breakaway to the finish, hit that jersey up and get an arrow. And my old buddy Jeff giving me a ride on. Thanks, Jeff. I need to get a longer cord on my headphones. They're rubbing on my my jawline in there. Starting to hurt. Throw the beard back so it doesn't rub. What's your distance of your time trial, Rogers? What kind of speed is that? 2135 miles per hour. Pretty smoking time. My brain doesn't think in KPH, Rogers. Sorry. My fastest ever pace has been like 27.4 miles per hour, I believe. That was a 40K. Hey Mike, yeah. Every once in a while you hear me clip a toe on the front of the treadmill. I'm overrunning the treadmill. Okay, yeah, 28.1, yeah. I think on a 10 miler I could get there. But that's a smoking fast time. Meters. Yeah, I think that would be still be doable. Over 10 miles. It'd be a hard effort, that's for sure. 28 miles per hour is no joke. I could do it on Zwift, Rogers. I'm not sure about in real life. In real life, I actually have to get aero and tuck down and... We're gonna be on the TT bike tonight though, so we're gonna get a little position work done. Got the TT bike on the trainer right now. Chris, I'll trade you. We have to search for hills around here. Everything's flat. Guys, we got a couple minutes left. Frequency, I don't think. No, it might be. No, no incline. My camera is probably just about 6 inches above my eye level, maybe a little higher. Yeah, Big Mac, I don't know. Last year when I time trialed outside, my time trial FTP was about 15, 20 watts under my road bike FTP because of the position. That would still put me at... You know, I was time trialing around 300 watts last year. If I had that same relative gap, I'd be time trialing, I don't know, 325, 330 now. At a similar perceived effort. So, yeah, I'm anxious to see what it'll do. So, guys, here on Zwift Community Live, getting ready to wrap up here. Got Scotty coming around in about an hour. From now, Scotty will be starting his group ride. Then, directly following Scotty, there's the Tour of California group ride going, I believe. So, you guys stick around tonight. Got a lot of stuff going on here on channel. I'm gonna jump straight from here over to my bike, so I'll be going live on my own Beam channel and probably 5-10 minutes after finishing up here, I'll be jumping on over there. Doing a little bit of a ride too, so feel free to come over and check us out there. And then I believe one or two things on the calendar tomorrow. I know Nathan's traveling, so some of the race coverage is a little light this week, but those will get picked up again in the future, I'm sure. Nathan's a little bit out of town right now, so I appreciate you guys hanging out with me. get rid of those headphones. They're rubbing on my neck. Got a good nice run in here. I hadn't run for 2 weeks, so I needed this. Finally got my heart rate to read right after about 2.5 miles into it. But I think this is it for me on Zwift Community Live this week. We'll be coming back over next week, doing some similar things, probably a run and a ride or a run and a race again next week. So, I appreciate you guys hanging out. I'm going to jump off here so I can pick up a group ride here in about 9 minutes. So, thanks for hanging out with me. Yeah, Terrell, thanks for that link. Check out ZwiftCommunityLive.com. There is a calendar over there. All the events. Terrell may have had something to do with this too, but man, the artwork that they're doing to get the word out on our rides, that tweet that they put out today, kind of blew me away, the artwork they did. They snapped one of my finisher photos from a try, put that on there. It was awesome. So I appreciate all the work they're doing over there, trying to get all the marketing and the PR out there and build the community. So it's pretty awesome. Thanks for hanging out with me, guys. I'm going to sign off here, and we'll talk to you all next time.